beam of light is sent through an aquarium. If a convex glass lens, as shown in the diagram, is held in the water, where does it focus the beam? Seconds left. Okay, we're close to 70%. Let's see if we can get to that to 100%. So go ahead, talk to your neighbor.
So that part doesn't matter. It's just from water to glass to water.
Right, exactly. You're in the aquarium tank, but it's like you've got these parallel beams coming in. You've got the parallel beam coming in, going air, glass, air. And so each of those changes is going to have a much higher magnitude, which means the ratio of the angles is going to be much higher. So you're going to have more dramatic angle shifts going air, glass, air than you're going to have going water, glass, water.
This thing that we did for the last problem, this is air, glass, air.
Right. No.
You're saying the difference is just the angle.
You've got this angle coming in like this. It's going to bend like that, right?
And then the second one.
Whereas if you have same thing, and this is water. The same. Water is about
1.3.
Right.
And then the same is true on the way out.
Right.
Exactly. 20
more seconds. 80 seconds is going to be in reverse, but the angle is still going to be like this.
Yeah.
But so far, we had a small miracle. We went from 69% correct to 100% correct. Wow, but we still are missing four responses, so let's have those last four people respond. 62, still 100%. This is amazing. 63, 100%. Wow, I'm impressed. Those of you who got it right very effectively taught those who made it wrong. And in the process, everybody really learns. But imagine that we were pouring in a liquid that has exactly the index of refraction of water. What would happen? So imagine it's not an aquarium filled with water, but some kind of, I think glycerin is something that's pretty close to glass. And you put that lens in there. What would happen to this parallel?